Welcome to all. Myself Professor Deshmukh. We have to see in this topic that is a problem based on dynamic vibrations, or you can say damp vibrations. So what exactly is the damp vibrations? Everybody knows that there is something resistance to the vibration that is called as damp vibrations. And free damp vibrations means what? That is we called as what? Viscous damping. Free means what? There is no external forces we are applying. That is called as what? The free vibrations. Now see the figure. Figure contains the spring having mass, spring having stiffness K, or you can say S in this case. Then again, there is a damper delta, damper C, you can say the damper factor. Then again, what are the forces are acting? That is a spring force S into X. Then again, the deflection, or can say the force due to the damper, that is called S into dx into dt, that is equal to what? C into x dot. Then again stiffness S into x. These are the forces. And exactly opposite to this, that there is the inertia force, that is m d2x upon dt square. So these are the forces acting on the spring mass and damper system. Now there is something, equations of the motions becomes. So what is in this case? So that is m d2x upon dt square. Is equal to minus c into x dx upon dt plus s dot x. So where it from? It is very easy that from that particular the forces acting on the system that we have to see. So that will be calculated by this considerations. After the putting all this value, what we got here? That is d2x plus cx. C upon m into dx upon dt plus s upon m into x. So again just resolve into the some particular forces in terms of k. K square into e into kt e raised to kt plus c into m into k into e raised to kt plus s upon m e raised to kt, that is equal to 0. So by simplifications we got that k square plus c by m into k plus s upon m, that is equal to 0. So minus c by m plus minus under root of c upon m by k square minus 4 into s. Divided by 2, okay. So that is equal to minus c upon twice m plus minus under root of c by twice m bracket square in minus s upon m. The two roots of the equations are k1 is equal to minus c upon twice m plus under root of c upon twice m bracket square minus s by m. And k2, similarly, minus c upon twice m minus under root of c upon twice m bracket square minus s upon m. So same are there, only the difference is that c upon twice m plus minus. So some of the conditions are there when the roots are equal. Under that condition, c upon twice m bracket square is greater than s upon m. When the roots are complex conjugate, under that condition, overdamping s upon m greater than s upon twice m bracket square. then again roots are complex conjugate under that conditions. S upon m bracket greater than c upon twice m bracket square, just difference is opposite to the overdamping conditions. Underdamping is opposite to the, or you can say reverse to the overdamp. Now when the roots are equal, that is critical damping, so c upon twice m bracket square is equal to s upon m. So this is conditions for the critical damping. When the two roots are equal, under that condition the critical damping is exist. Thus the motion is again aperiodic. The critical damping coefficient cc may be obtained by substituting the value cc for c in the conditional critical speed. So cc is equal to 2m under root of s upon m, that is twice m omega n. Okay, omega n is equal to under root of k by m, just put all these values. Now the damping factor or the damping ratio, what is that? The damping factor is equal to c upon cc, that is equal to c twice m into omega n. Cc is equal to twice 2 pi omega n. Now there is a logarithmic decrement. X1 upon x2 is equal to a e raised to at minus at upon a e raised to minus a t plus tp, that is equal to e raised to atp. This is the constant. So delta is equal to log e x1 upon x2 is equal to a dot tp, that is equal to a into 2 pi under root of omega n square minus a square. Omega d is equal to omega n square minus a square. So after simplification we got that 2 pi into c divided by under root of cc square minus c square, where cc is equal to twice m omega n and a is equal to c upon twice m. So in general the amplitude of this vibration reduction factor x1 upon x2, x2 upon x3, similarly up to xn upon xn plus 1, that is e raised to at into p, that is constant. Logarithmic decrement, delta is equal to log e xn upon xn plus 1. Now this is a particular problem based on the logarithmic decrement. It's quite easier. Okay, so that we will see in the next lecture. So before this we are seeing these formulations. Okay, so thank you to all for listening this.